Hello everyone and welcome to another video in the Ubuntu video series. And in this video I'm going to talk about Microsoft Visual Studio Code, and I'm going to talk about the installation of this particular application and also why I think this is one of the best code editors available currently. So let's start. So for installation, there are two options. You can either go into Ubuntu Software Center and you can search for Visual Studio Code. And you can install it from here. And or the other option is you can download the Debian package for the Visual Studio Code from the official Visual Studio site. So for that, I'm going to show you this installation method from the actual Microsoft Visual Studio site. So for that, you need to go into the Visual Studio Code site, so which is https://code.visualstudio.com/download. So let's go in there and we will download the Debian package from there. You can see the Debian package there. So let's download the Debian package. And there it's downloading. And once the package is downloaded, I'm just going to open the package. And once I do that, it will open up in Ubuntu Software Center for installation. And then we are going to install this package. Let's go ahead and install this and provide our password. There it is. It is installed now. And so let's now start and open the package. So I'm just going to search. And let's open that. And I'm going to add that to my favorites. Now, why did I choose Visual Studio Code? So first thing I wanted to mention is that this is built for multiple platforms. It can run on Windows, it can run on Linux, it can run on Mac OS. So it is cross-platform and you will get same experience whether you, regardless of which operating system you're running. So the next thing I wanted to mention is that VS Code is very powerful and lightweight. And as you can see, it's really lightweight and there's not so much detail into the menu options here, but at the same time is really powerful as well. There is support available for TypeScript, Python, HTML, SQL, Java, C#, etc. So there's a whole heap of different platforms that it can support and the languages that it can support, and at the same time it's very fast and smooth in running. You can explore for files and folders over here. And you can search for stuff here. You can have a look at your source control. You can do your debugging in here. And you can see the extensions that are available over here. Let's have a look at the extensions. And you can see the number of extensions that are available over here. It has a whole heap of extensions available. Regardless of the language that you use to build your application, it has all the different kinds of extensions that are available. Be it Java-based stuff or be it Microsoft-based stuff, everything is available in here. It has extensions available for your Git repository handling. It has extensions available for Docker, for example, Angular. And as you can see, so many things are available over here. Your HTML editing is available. Your NPM package management is available. JavaScript ES6 packages are available. CSS support is available. React.js tools are available. So there is no end of extensions. So it is full of all the different extensions supporting the different applications frameworks that are out there. So this is one of the best things that I found out. And whichever platform you're working on, you will have something most likely available for you. So setting up your project in Visual Studio Code is very easy and straightforward. As you can see, the menu options are pretty minimalist and very lightweight. So in order to set up the project in here, you've got a couple of options. You can either open a folder or you can create your own workspace. Opening a folder into my workspace, we'll just list down all the contents of that folder. As an example, I have a couple of projects here, so I'm going to open one of them. And there the project is. And I can also save this as a workspace. And save it. And as you can see, I have already created one. So I'm going to say replace it. And I can also add any other folders that I wish into that workspace by using the add folder to workspace button. And in this case, the folder could be under the same path or it could be any other path. And there it is. I have two projects within my workspace. The IDE settings are highly customizable, and in order to change them, you need to go to File, Preferences and Settings. And there are the global settings, which are the default settings, and there are user settings, which you can actually use to override your default settings. And as you can see here, there are different kinds of settings available, which are specific to the editor, workspace, workbench, Windows, File Explorer, and all the different kind of languages that are available, and also source control specific settings. The next thing to show is that you have a command palette available, which you can access using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Shift+P, and you can use it to issue a number of commands, and these are like shortcuts to the different tasks that are available. There is a very good feature available on VS Code, and if what you're doing is only editing code, you can enable the Zen mode, and you can do that by going to View and then going to toggle Zen mode, or you can press Ctrl+K and then Z, and all this is going to do is just show you the code, and then you can toggle that back again by pressing Ctrl+K and Z. Some other noticeable features available in VS Code is that IntelliSense is provided out of the box for languages such as JavaScript, TypeScript, JSON, HTML, CSS, LESS, and SAS. You can use the shortcut Ctrl+P to quick open your files, and your source code control Git integration is available out of the box, and you can perform various Git operations from within the IDE. And last but not the least, you also have terminal integration available within VS Code. And to do that, you go to View and you press Integrated Terminal, and you can perform various terminal operations from here. So I hope you have a wonderful time coding in VS Code, and thank you very much for watching my video.